In this next segment, we're going to learn how to insert pictures in our document. To insert pictures, go somewhere in the document where you want to insert a new picture, and then go into the Insert tab, and then click on the drop-down for pictures. You can go in the photo browser, which would be navigating pictures in your computer, or a picture from a file, and then go to wherever your folder with the picture is, click on the picture file, and then click on insert. Once you have inserted the picture, click on it. A new tab shows up as part of the ribbon. At this point, you can make color corrections to it. You can apply a variety of different themes, very similar to the tables that we learned earlier. Furthermore, you can go under the border, change the picture effects, and unlike the version of Word in Windows, which gives you a live preview, in the Mac version, as of the time of this recording, it does not do that for you. It does not give you a live preview as you're going through those options. Under the position, you can select where you want this picture in the document. Let's say in the top right of this page or the bottom right of this document, and it's going to place it automatically in the location that we specified. If we don't like it, you can also drag it around in the document. Now, you'll notice that it's adjusting the text around the document. This is referred to as the text wrapping. So in our case, we moved it and it adjusted it automatically. However, you can control that after we clicked on the picture and we go to the picture format tab. On the right hand side, there is this drop down where you have the square, which is right now. So there's a square around the text, or you can have it through the text or tight around the text. One other thing to demonstrate here is that you can resize it to make it smaller or larger by using the handles. Typically, it's best to use the one on the corners because that'll make it proportionate. You can also rotate the picture and you use this handle on the top section of it. The reason why I'm doing this is to show how the text wrapping works. So I have the text wrapping tight around it, and therefore it's going to put the text all around the image. If I don't want it like that and I want it square, then it's going to move the text outside the area. If you have multiple pictures in the document and you want to overlap them, you can control which one to bring forward or to send backward. One other important concept to remember is that once you insert a picture in a document, you can crop the picture by selecting it and then clicking on the crop option. So you activate the crop functionality, and then you can adjust these handles as to what you want to crop out of it. So notice you have to hold the mouse on these dark lines when it changes to like a T on its side, and then drag it to the left. It's going to make this smaller. Once we are set with the location that we desire, then click again on crop and it's going to apply that cropping to the image. If you double click on the image, notice that the format picture along with additional properties panel will display, and from here you can adjust settings related to this newly inserted image in the document.